إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن الأصدق الكلام كلام الله، والخير الحديث حديث محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، كل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، وبعد. حياكم الله إخوانا في الله، ويقص الله عز وجل that he gives us the tawfiq to guide my tongue to that which is beloved to him and that which is correct according to his deen. The affair, Ikhwan, of the hellfire is not an easy affair, and not an easy affair likewise to even talk about it. So we ask Allah to aid us in that. For verily, Ikhwan, the Salaf, when they would merely hear the mention of hellfire or anything that would remind them from the hellfire, then it would make them tremble, it would make them fear, and in some cases it would make them become sick. سمع عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه رجلا يتحجد في الليل ويقرأ سورة الطور. On occasion, عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه, he heard an individual performing the night prayer, and he heard him recite سورة الطور. And he says, فَلَمَّا بَلَغَ إِلَى قَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى إِنَّ عَذَابَ رَبِّكَ لَوَاقِعَ مَا لَهُ مِنْ دَافِعَ قال عمر رب الكعب الحق ثم رجع إلى منزله فمرض شهرا ويعوده الناس لا يدرون ما مرضه. When Umar bin Khattab heard that verse, he heard an individual reciting in the night prayer, Surah At-Tur. And when he came to that verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentions, indeed, the punishment of your Lord will occur. That punishment regarding the hellfire, of it there is no preventer. No one can prevent that punishment. Umar bin Khattab, just hearing that verse, he said he returned to his home. It mentions he returned to his home and then he became ill. And he became ill for a period of 1 month. And the people would visit Umar, but they did not know what made Umar ill. And that was regarding hearing a verse about the hellfire. So how will it be, Ikhwan, for us to have to mention the descriptions of the hellfire, its people, the different types of punishment? And for those of you that have to listen to that, and how will that be? So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He aids us in that. Regarding the hellfire, Ikhwan, it is already present. As Allah Azza wa Jal, He has stated, وَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ الَّتِي عُدَّتْ لِلْكَافِرِينَ. Fear of fire that has been prepared for the disbelievers. So from here we understand that the hellfire is already present, already been prepared for the mujrimeen. وَقَالَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ إنا أعتدنا للظالمين نارا أحاط بهم سرادقها. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, we have prepared for the zalimun, the wrongdoers, the mujrimeen, a fire whose walls will be surrounding them. So the hellfire, ikhwan, is a creation that is already being prepared. Why is the existence of the hellfire? The Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he has mentioned in a hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, بِنِسْبَةِ الْجَنَّةِ هَذَا رَحْمَتِي, regarding paradise, then this is my mercy. وَالنَّارُ وَجَهَنَّمْ عَذَابِي, and the hellfire is my punishment. وَقَالَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ قُلْ نَارَ جَهَنَّمَ شَدُّ حَرَّا لَوْ كَانُوا يَفْقَهُونَ. Allah Azza wa Jal, he says, the fire of the hellfire is more intense in heat if only they could understand. If only they could understand. Regarding the hellfire, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he commands us in the Quran. He commands us in the Quran to save ourselves from it. He commands us in the Quran to save ourselves and our families. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, O you who believe, save yourselves and your families from the hellfire. A hellfire whose fuel is men and stone. Men and stone, ikhwan. And that's the reality. That's the reality of hellfire. That it is fueled by men and stone. A fire, ikhwan, that is fueled by men and stone, that made the Salaf tremble. Fearful that that mankind, man and stone, fearful that they may be those men that are fueling the hellfire. Umar ibn Khattab was from the greatest examples of that. Always fearing. Coming close to the fire that we have here. Whenever he would kindle a fire, he would draw close to it. And the fire of this life would make him reflect regarding the hellfire. And then he would look at the hellfire and he would address himself. Ya Umar, hal laka sabr ala hadha? Umar, do you have the patience upon this? Meaning this fire. This fire is only the fire of the dunya. And this is how we should be, ikhwan. Always asking Allah Azza wa Jal salvation from the hellfire. Always requesting from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he doesn't make us of those men that will fuel this hellfire. A hellfire, ikhwan, that is explained in hadith regarding the huge size of this creation. Regarding the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَجِيَ يَوْمَ إِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمْ, and on that day the hellfire will be brought forth. Regarding that statement, there's a hadith that explains. فَعَنْ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ بْنِ مُسْعُودٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَىٰ عَنْ أَنَّ النَّبِيَّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ قَالَ يُعْتَ بِالنَّارِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ لَعَى سَبْعُونَ أَلْفَ زَمَامٍ مَعَ كُلُّ زَمَامٍ سَبْعُونَ أَلْفَ مَلَكٍ يَجُرُّونَهَا. رواه مسلم. Ibn Mas'ud, he says that the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that the hellfire will be brought forth on the day of judgment, and it will be brought forth, and from it there will be 70,000 rains, leashes, 70,000. Each rain, there will be 70,000 angels, yajurunaha, pulling it and bringing it forth. Now just reflect upon that. each rain, there's 70,000 of them, and each one of them, there is 70,000 angels bringing forth the hellfire. Also on an occasion, Abu Huraira, he likewise narrates, كنا عند النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فسمعنا وجبة. He said, we were sitting with the messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, and then we heard a sound, and that sound, as the ulama mentioned, was heard by the sahaba as well as the messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. So the messenger said to them, أتدرون ما هذا? Do you know what that was? So they replied, Allah wa Rasulu a'lam. Allah and His Messenger know best. قال هذا حجر أرسل الله في جهنم منذ 70 خريفة, أي منذ 70 سنة. فالآن حين انتهى إلى قعرها. The Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that sound that you heard was a stone. A stone that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cast it into the hellfire. And it has been fallen for 70 years. It has been falling down 70 years. And now that noise that you heard, it touched the base of the Jahannam. After 70 years. If you was to go to the tallest building that we have, Ala Zahir al-Ard, and to cast something, how long would it take till it reached its bottom? A minute, if anything, less than a minute. How about, Ikhwan, something that we cannot even comprehend, falling for the time span of 70 years, and it reaches the bottom after 70 years. La ilaha illallah, to make you realize how huge the Jahannam is. وَنَبِي رَيْرَةَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَلْعَنْهُ قَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ ذِرْسُ الْكَافِرُ مِثْلُ أُحُدْ وَمَكْعَدُهُ مِنَ النَّارِ مَسِيرَةُ الثَّلَاثِ, أي ثلاثة أيام. The Messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, ذِرْسُ الْكَافِرُ, the molotov of the disbeliever in the hellfire will be the size of Uhud. Now for many of you, Uhud is just a name. But for those of you that have traveled to Saudi Arabia, in the blessed city of the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will see a huge mountain that stretches for kilometers. There's not a place in Medina that you stand except that you can see it. Obviously your view will be blocked now due to the hotels. But back in the day, there wasn't a place in Medina except that you could see Uhud. It stretches for kilometers. The molar tooth of a disbeliever will be that big. And that place where they sit in the hellfire, the area, the size of that area, it mentions that if you was to travel for three days, and some of the narrations, it mentions al-raqib al-musri', a fast rider, the distance that he covers in 3 days is that area which they will sit. Meaning that's how huge their size will be. And what is the hikmah and the wisdom behind this? As Ahl al-Ilm, they have mentioned, in order to taste the punishment. The more there is to burn, then the more punishment it is. The Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he has said that there are three, ثلاثة لا يدخلون الجنة, that the three will not enter Jannah. مدمن الخمر, the one who is an alcoholic. وقاطي الرحم, the one who severs the ties of kingship. And the one that performs the magic and believes that the magic, not that we don't believe magic exists, but in carrying out and believing that there is tawfiq in magic. These are the individuals that will not enter into paradise. The Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said regarding, he has taken a covenant regarding the one that dies, and he dies an alcoholic, dies while he is drinking alcohol.
Then it mentions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala لَيَسْقِيهِ مِنْ تِينَةِ الْخَبَالِ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make him drink from تِينَةِ الْخَبَالِ. So then it was questioned to the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that what is his تِينَةِ الْخَبَالِ, and then he replied by saying أُرْقُ أَحْلَ النَّارِ, the sweat of the people of the hellfire, أو عُصَارَةُ أَحْلِ النَّارِ, or the waste from the people of the hellfire. So these are just some of the things that are mentioned, Rikwan, regarding the severe punishment. Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah ta'ala, he said some kalam, Ikhwan, to show dikkat al-fahmi, how precise his understanding was. He said, مَا ظُنُّكَ بِقَوْمٍ قَامُوا عَلَىٰ أَقْدَامِهِمْ خَمْسِينَ أَلْفَ سَنَةً. They said, what would make you realize, or what do you think about the person that will stand on his feet 50,000 years? Standing for 50,000 years. What does Hassan al-Basri intend here? If you took what our brothers mentioned earlier, Allah yafadhum, what is his 50,000 years? What is he? What's the intent here? Yawm al-Qiyamah. So Hassan al-Basri says, so what about the one that stands 50,000 years? وَلَمْ يَأْكُلُ فِيهَا أَكْلَةً, and he will not have no food. وَلَمْ يَشْرُبُ فِيهَا شَرْبَةً, and he will not have no drink. حَتَّى إِنْقَطَعَ أَعْنَاقُهُمْ عَطَشًا وَاحْتَرَقَتْ أَجْوَافُهُمْ جَوْعًا ثُمَّ انْصَرَفْ بِهَا إِلَى النَّارِ فَيُسْقَوْنَ مِنْ عَيْنٍ عَانِيَةٍ قَدْ آنَ حَرَّهَا وَإِشْتَدَّ نُضِجُحَا. He said, how will it be for those individuals that their throats have become severed out of thirst and their insides are burnt out of hunger? Then they will be taken into the hellfire and they will be given to drink from a scorching hot spring that will increase in heat due to them. So Hassan al-Basri is talking about the people of the hellfire, that not only did they have the ordeal of 50,000 years, hunger, hungry, and then after that the ordeal is the hellfire, and all that they will have to drink from there is from a scorching spring that severs their necks and burns their insides. Reflecting like, subhanAllah, after such a long trial, look what they have. And what will make you realize, Ikhwan, regarding the heat of the hellfire. Regarding the heat of the hellfire, the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has explained in the hadith, he said, اشتكتِ النار إلى ربها فقالت يا ربي أكل بعضي بعضا فنفسني فجعل لها نصفين نصف في الشتاء ونصف في الصيف فشدة ما تجدون من البرد من زمحريرها وشدة ما تجدون من حر سمومها. The Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that the hellfire complained to his Lord. He said, oh my Lord, parts of me is eating other parts due to the severe heat. The heat of the hellfire is causing to eat other parts. So the hellfire complained to his Lord and said, oh Allah, rough translation here means, allow me to breathe. Allow me to cool down. So that Allah Azza wa Jal allowed it to breathe twice. To let off a breath twice. One in the summer and one in the winter. So the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that heat that you feel, the heat that you feel in the summer is from the breath of the hellfire. And that extreme cold that you feel in the winter, then that likewise is a breath from the hellfire. From the wisdom of Allah, وَهُوَ قَادِرَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can punish in the hellfire with nar and with barad.
وهو قادر على كل شيء. And it's not a contradiction. فإذا قاله الصادق والمصدوق نصدق. If the message of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم has informed us that, then we believe. How? The ilm is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But just reflect. In the lands that we live in, when that heat comes, then you find those who are disbelievers, they strip until they bear. وَبِسْأَسَفِ الشَّدِيدِ Even you'll find that the Muslims, they blind follow them likewise in that manner, in the clothing which they wear. So next time, just reflect that that heat where you are becoming happy and jolly, that heat where you are stripping or wearing clothes which are indecent, then know that is a breath from the hellfire. والذي دخل النار ليس لديه إلا الندم الشديد. The one that will enter the hellfire, he will have nothing but regret. He will have nothing but regret. قال الله عز وجل كلما نضجت جلودهم بدلناهم جلودا غيرها ليذوقوا العذاب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, and we shall burn them in the fire as often as their skins are roasted through, and we shall change them for other skins. Meaning those skins, once they are burnt, the punish doesn't finish there. The punishment doesn't finish there. The skins are brought back again in order to increase that punishment. نحل النار, they will say, وَمَا لَنَا مِنْ مَحِيصٍ. أحل النار, they will say, and there is no place of refuge for us. No place of refuge, no helper. And what they want, well, that Allah does them away. That they no longer feel, or they no longer live. But from the wisdom and from the punishments of Allah, is that it is such that those who are in the hellfire, their state is what? لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا. They will neither die and they will neither live. It is continuous. It will never come to an end. Something, ikhwan, that we cannot even comprehend. And this is why the Salaf, they used to say, كيف تبيع الآخرتك? How can you sell your hereafter? How can you give away your hereafter for a mere pleasure, moments of pleasure? Moments of pleasure, bas. Shahwat al-sa'a. A short period where you have that love, where it feels sweet. But look at the consequence. Never ending. The punishment in the hellfire, it is never ending. فالطعام في نار نار. So the food in the hellfire, it is fire. والشراب في النار نار. And the drink in the hellfire is fire. And the clothes that you will wear is likewise fire. Ibn Abbas رضي الله تعالى عنه, he says, تبارك من جعل لأهل النار من النار ثيابا. He said, blessed is he, the one that has made garments from fire. Blessed is he, that he brings about for the people of the hellfire, garments that are from fire. سَرَابِيلُهُمْ مِنْ قَطِرَانِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, their garments will be of qatiran. What does that mean? Qatiran. هُوَ النُّحَاسِ الَّذِي أَذِيبٍ بِنْ شِدَّةِ الْغُلْيَانِ. That is melted and boiling copper. Melted and boiling copper. This is the clothes that will be dressed for the people of the hellfire. And it continues, ikhwan. لَهُمْ ثِيَابٌ مِنْ نَارٍ. They will have garments from fire. يُسُبُّ مِنْ فَوْكِ رُؤُوسِهِمْ الْجَهِيمِ. He said, and they will be poured, boiling water will be poured over their heads. It will be poured over their heads, Ikhwan, and it will make everything vanish away and their skin. وَلَهُمْ مَقَامِعُ مِنْ حَدِيدٍ. And they will have hooked rods of iron. كُلَّمَا أَرَادُوا أَن يَخْرِجُوا مِنْهَا مِنْ غَمٍّ وَعِيدُوا فِيهَا وَذُوقُوا الْعَذَابِ الْحَرِيقِ. That every time they would want to flee away from anguish, that they will be put back in order for them to taste the punishment. Regarding the verse, الذين كفروا وصدوا عن سبيل الله زدناهم عذابا فوق العذاب بما كانوا يفسدون. Regarding that verse, that verily those who believe and flee away and block the way and the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we will increase their punishment, punishment upon punishment. Ibn Mas'ud, he said, that is ziyadat al-aqarib. He said that will be the increasement of scorpions. Scorpions at the size, scorpions the size of camels, to increase the punishment of the mujrimeen. Wallah, ikhwan, question is, what are we doing? Wallah, question to myself first. What are we doing when we hear such things? Their despair will be so much, ikhwan, that the people of the hellfire, they will look for anything that can save them. They will be desperate. They will even call to the inhabitants of paradise. فَقَالَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ وَنَادَى أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ أَصْحَابَ الْجَنَّةِ أَنْ عَفِيضُوا عَلَيْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ أَوْ مِمَّا رَزَقَكُمُ اللَّهُ. So the people of the hellfire, out of their desperation, they will call to the people of paradise. And they will say, pour upon us some of the bounties that Allah has given you. Pour upon us some water. Anything which Allah عز وجل has blessed you with. And they will reply by saying, قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ حَرَّمَ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ. Verily Allah has made that haram upon the disbelievers. الَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا دِينَهُمْ لَحْوًا وَلَعِبًا. The ones that took their deen as mere play and amusement and as a joke. This deen of Islam that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent as a mercy to mankind, they took as a joke. They took it as mockery. وَغَرَّتْهُمُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. And this world, it made them drown. The world deceived them, and they were drowned in this world. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, فَالْيَوْمْ نَنْسَاهُمْ كَمَا نَسُوا لِقَى يَوْمِهِمْ هَذَا. We will make them forget, or we will forget them, just as they forgot regarding this encounter. Have they forgot that they would meet Allah, standing in front of Allah, regarding the punishments? Have they forgot? Then we shall forget them this day. And they will be desperate. They will even call to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for aid and for help. That's how desperate they will be. Then Allah azza wa jal, he will say to them, أَلَمْ تَكُونْ آيَاتِ تُتْلَ عَلَيْكُمْ. Was my verses not recited to you? فَعَلَيْكُمْ كُنْتُمْ بِهَا تُكَذِّبُونَ. But you denied my verses. And then they will say, قَالُوا رَبَّنَا غَلَبَتْ عَلَيْنَا شِكْوَتُنَا وَكُنَّا قَوْمًا ظَالِينَ. And they will say, oh Allah, wretchedness overpowered us, and we were from those who were led astray, the wrongdoers. رَبَّنَا أَخْرِجْنَا مِنْهَا. Oh Allah, take us out of here. Allah, take us out of here. فَإِنْ أُدْنَا فَإِنْ دَظَالِمِينَ. Allah, if you was to take us away from here and bring us back to the earth, and if then we did not follow your way, then truly then we are the wrongdoers. Then Allah Azza wa Jal will say, قَالَتْ سَهُ فِيهَا. Then Allah Azza wa Jal will say, Remain therein. وَلَا تُكَلِّمُونَ. And do not speak to me. No aid on that day, ikhwan. That day there is no aid, not from Allah, not from nobody. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla al-Afiyah. The humiliation, ikhwan, of turning to Allah and Allah telling you that you have no aid. Allah telling you, remain therein. And Allah telling you, remain quiet. What an azab that is, ikhwan. What a punishment that is. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jalla that it does not make us from those individuals. Allah Azza wa Jalla has ordered us to order with the good and forbid the evil. And we should act upon that. Allah Azza wa Jalla, He mentions in the Quran, يَا أَيُّوَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لِمَا تَقُولُ مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ. Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran, O you who believe, why do you say that which you do not do? O you believe, why do you say that which you do not do? Verily this is most hateful. It is a hateful thing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you say something or you command something and yet you do not act upon it. Listen to this hadith, ikhwan, regarding the individuals that do this. Individuals that call to good, but they themselves, unfortunately, in their actions and their speech, are not doing what they are calling to. فَجَاءَ رَجُلٌ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. There will be a person that will be brought forth on يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. فَيُلْقِ فِي النَّارِ. And then he will be casted into hellfire. And he will be carrying his insides, intestines, and he will be circling in the hellfire. And then the people of the hellfire will say to him, فَيَجْتَمَ أَحْلَ النَّارَ عَلَيْهِ. So the people of hellfire, they will gather around him and they will say to him, فَيَقُولُنَ أَيْ فُلَانُ أَوْ such and such, مَا شَأْنُكَ أَلَيْسَ كُنْتَ تَعْمُلُنَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَانِ الْمُنْكَرِ. Wasn't you the one that will call us to good or command us to do good and you used to forbid the evil? Aren't you such and such? Then he will say, قَالْ كُنْتُ أَمَرُكُمْ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. I used to order you with good, وَلَا آتِي, and I never used to do it myself. وَأَنْهَاكُمْ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَآتِي, and I used to forbid you from the evil, but I used to do the evil myself. It's not enough, ikhwan, just to have that knowledge. It's not enough just to have knowledge of what we should and shouldn't do. But rather we have to make tatbiq. And that in itself, ikhwan, that dua we should always ask Allah for. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the tawfiq to have ilm and nafi', and then thereon after to make tatbiq. That we may be able to act upon what we have learned, the knowledge that we have, what we call to, that we act upon it. Regarding the food, ikhwan, لَيْسَ لَهُمْ طَعَامٌ إِلَّا مِنْ ضَرِيعٍ. The people of the hellfire, their food, it will be a poisonous thorny plant. And that will neither nourish them nor avail against them hunger. قَطَادَ رَحِمَ اللَّهِ, he says, من أدرع طعام وأشبع, that this type of thorny plant, it is the most severe and humiliating food. ولا طعام إلا من غسلين لا يأكله إلا الخاطئون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentions that the food for the wrongdoers in the hellfire, it is the pus that comes out of the wound. This is the food of the people of the hellfire. Regarding zakum, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned, a tree which stems from the base of the jahannam, shajaratun khabitha, a very ugly tree, and it mentions karu'us shayateen, and the branches is like the heads of the shayateen. This is a tree in jahannam. Listen to what the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said regarding this tree. لو قطرت قطرة من الزقوم في الدنيا, that if there was only a drop or a small piece of this zakum upon the earth that we live today, just a small piece. فسدت كل شيء على الأرض. It will corrupt every single thing on the earth. All the provisions to mankind, it will corrupt it. Just a small piece. So then the Messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, then he said, فَكَيْفَ بِمَنْ يَكُونَ سَقُونَ طَعَامَهُ. How will it be then for the one that has to eat this? How will it be for the one whose food will be zakum, when a tiny piece of zakum upon the earth will corrupt everything, all provisions? So the Messenger, even then, even he reflected, and even he said, then how will it be? What will be the state of the one that has to eat this? نسأل الله العافية. أغلال في أعناقهم وسلاسل يسحبون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentions that the people of the hellfire, they will have iron collars around their necks and chains, and they shall be dragged with these chains and these collars. ثُمَّ فِي سِلْسِلَةٍ ذَرُعَهَا سَبْعُونَ ذِرَاعًا فَاسْلَقُوا. Allah commands that the one that will be in the hellfire, to seize him and fetter him and tie him with 70 cubits of chain. Al-Hasan al-Basri, he mentioned from the wisdom of why they will have these heavy chains and these iron collars around them is that they remain fixed in the depth of the hellfire and they do not raise with the burning. So after hearing that, Ikhwan, after hearing just some of the descriptions, then this is just some of the descriptions. Wallah, 1 hour is not enough. It doesn't give the haq to speak about the hellfire and its people and its punishments. But we tried to gather whatever we could gather. But upon hearing that, Ikhwan, is it really worth it? Especially when you hear the following hadith. The following hadith, Ikhwan, for those of you of understanding will understand and will take heed. وَعَنْ عَنَسِ بْنِ مَالِكَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهُ أَنَّ النَّبِيَّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ قَالَ يُعْتَى بِأَنْعَمِ أَهْلِ الدُّنْيَا مِنْ أَهْلِ النَّارِ فَيُصْبَغُ فِي النَّارِ صَبْغَةً ثُمَّ يُقَالُ يَا ابْنِ آدَمَ رَأَيْتَ خَيْرًا قَطْ هَلْ مَرَّ بِكَ نَعِيمٌ قَطْ فيقول لا والله يا ربي. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he says that the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that they will be the most favored person brought forth on Yawm al-Qiyamah. But he is a person of hellfire. What does favored mean? Not favored by hidayah, guidance, and taqwa. But he was given the luxuries of this world. The luxuries of this world he was given. And look what it says here. An'am ahl dunya. The one that is received the most from amongst the people upon the earth. He received the most by way of bounties and wealth. And to really reflect upon that, just look at the individuals that we have on the face of the earth today. Look at the richest ones that they said, such and such is the richest person upon the face of the earth. Look at the mass of wealth that he has and what he possesses. You have individuals that own islands. This hadith is talking about the one that has been given the most. Look at his fate. The Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that individual that has given the most, he will come and he will be dipped into the hellfire. Merely dipped. So we can see the hellfire. Just a dip. And then he will be said to him, that did you see any good? Did any good reach you? Did any bliss reach you? And from the sight of the hellfire, from that one dip, just from that, seeing that has made him forget everything that he had on the dunya. Made him forget everything. And says, wallahi, I've never seen no good. Wallah, no good has come to me. Why? Because he knows what's awaiting him. And then it mentioned regarding يُعْتَى بِالنَّاسِ بُعْسًا فِي الدُّنْيَا مِنْ أَحْلِ الْجَنَّةِ. Then the one that was most trialed, the one that was poor, the one that was in difficulties in this dunya, وَلَكِنْ مُؤْمِنْ, a believer, مِنْ أَحْلِ الْجَنَّةِ, he is from the people of paradise. But he saw hardship, he saw trials, and he will be dipped into Jannah, paradise. Just a mere dip. And la ilaha illallah, what he sees, and what he sees is awaiting him. And then he will be said to him, did you see any hardship? Did you see any trials? And he said, la wallah, by Allah, no. By Allah, nothing came my way of difficulty. Because what he sees from paradise and the bliss and the mercy of Allah, what he's about to receive, has made him forget anything was in the dunya. Once again, ikhwan, myself and then my brothers and sisters, what are we doing? Where are we? What are we doing? When such clear proof has come to us, what are we doing is the question. Now we move on, ikhwan, to some of the ahwal of the salaf. How the salaf, they were, when they would reflect regarding the hellfire and its punishment.
قيل لسعيد بن جبير بلغنا أنك لم تضحقت.
It was said to Sa'id ibn Jubair, it has reached us that you never laugh. You never laugh. And then he said, كيف أضحق, how can I laugh? How? وَجَهَنَّمْ قَدْ سُعِرَتْ, and the hellfire is kindled to a fierce blaze. وَأَغْلَالْ قَدْ نُسِبَتْ, and the iron collars are fixed. وَالزَّبَانِيَ, he said, and the guards of the hellfire, they are already prepared. So how can I laugh? How can I smile? How can I laugh when these things are already being prepared?
Musa ibn Sa'ad قال كنا إذا جلسنا عند سفيان الثوري.
He says that when we was with Sufyan al-Thawri, كأن النار قد أحاط بنا لما نرى من خوفه. He said when we was with Sufyan al-Thawri, it was as if of those the hellfire was around us, due to the state that Sufyan al-Thawri would be in, from the fear that he would be in. He said, it was almost as if for those the hellfire was around us. This is because they had ilm al-yaqeen, because they had belief, ikhwan. They had belief in what Allah mentioned in the Quran. Bil full yaqeen, full certainty within their hearts that what has been mentioned is haqq. The promise of Allah Azza wa Jal is haqq, which caused him to be in that state.
Also, Umar bin Khattab radiallahu ta'ala, lamma tu'in, that you know Umar bin Khattab, an attempt was made to assassinate him, and he had severe stab wounds. So at that time, death was close. And then he said, radiallahu ta'ala an, لو أن لي طلع الأرض ذهبا لأفتديت به من عذاب الله قبل أن أراه.
He said, by Allah, if I had gold equal to the earth, I would have ransomed myself with it from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before I meet Allah yawm al-qiyamah. Who's saying this?
Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala an,
fearing the punishment of the hellfire.
Ma'a thalika qala an-nabiy sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ya Umar anta fil jannah.
Umar, you are in paradise.
Ma'a thalika that when Umar would walk, that the shaitan would move from his path. This is Umar. That the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that if there was to be a messenger after me, it would be Umar. مَعَ ذَلِكَ كُلَّهَا يَخَافْ مِنَ النَّارِ. With all of that, he still feared. Then what about us? How should we be? When a man has been told, you are in paradise, and yet he fears that it will be casted into the hellfire, then what about our hal? How should we be? بكى الحسن البصري رحمه الله فكيل ما يبقيك. Hassan al-Basri, he was crying. And then it was said to him, so what is it that makes you cry? He said, أخاف أن يطلني غدا في النار. He said, I fear that tomorrow will be casted into the hellfire and Allah will not mind. Fearing, not knowing where they were going. And remember, Ikhwan, who we're talking about. Hassan al-Basri, Umar ibn Khattab, Ashab al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the fear which they had. So in conclusion, Ikhwan, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Fear Allah. فَاتَّقُوا النَّارِ. Fear the fire. Fear the fire. And a way to fear the fire will be الْبُقَى مِنْ خَشَّةِ اللَّهِ. With the tears that are shed out of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said two types of eyes the hellfire will not touch. The eyes that shed tears when they are alone in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the eyes that guard the Muslims while they sleep. So if the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that these tears come by you fearing Allah will protect you against the hellfire, increase in making them tears come out. There is no shame in that. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq could not recite the Quran, could not lead Salah except that he would shed a tear. Umar ibn Khattab would have two black marks like laces on his face due to him crying. You cannot tell me that you're more of a man than Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu. There is no shame in crying, especially if you know that those tears that you were shed out of fear of Allah, them tears will come back to protect you. Likewise, increase in fasting. The Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, من سام يوما في سبيل الله, whomsoever fast a day for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove him away from the fire by the distance of 70 years. One day of fasting. Also, Ikhwan, from the means that will aid you is these gatherings. The gatherings where Allah Azza wa Jal is remembered. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sends out malaika. Malaika to go upon the earth to seek the gatherings where Allah is remembered. So the malaika, when they come to these gatherings, then when they return to Allah Azza wa Jal, then Allah will say to them, فَيَقُولْ لَهُمْ وَهُوَ أَحْلَمْ بِهِمْ. Then Allah will say to the angels, and Allah already knows the answer, but He says to the angels, مِمَّنْ يَتَعَوَّذُونَ. What is it that they seek refuge from? These individuals are in the gatherings that are remembering Allah. What do they seek? Or what do they seek refuge in? فَيَقُولُ مِنَ النَّارِ. From the hellfire. They seek refuge from the hellfire. فَيَقُولَ اللَّهُ وَهَلْ رَأَوْهَا. Then Allah will say to the angels, have they seen the hellfire? And then the angels will reply, قَالُوا لَا. Said, by Allah, they have not seen it. فَيَقُولَ اللَّهُ. Then Allah will say, كَيْفَ وَلَوْ رَآهَا. How will it be if they was to see the hellfire? فَيَقُولُونَ لَوْ رَآهَا كَانُوا أَشَدُّ مِنْهَا فِرَارًا وَأَشَدُّ مِنْهَا مُخَافَةً. He said, if the angels will say, if they was to see the hellfire, then they would flee from the hellfire. They would flee from the hellfire and they would increase in their fear. قَالْ فَيَقُولُ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, إني أشهدتكم إني قد غفرت لهم. That I bear witness that I have forgiven them. La ilaha illallah. I have forgiven them. Due to what? Attending the gatherings of where Allah is mentioned. So this is why, ikhwan, alhamdulillah, not everyone can attend the masjid. We know. And alhamdulillah, with the means today, we have radios, everybody listens. But the fadl, ikhwan, cannot be taken away from the gatherings. The gatherings where you come, where Allah is mentioned, is something that will aid you. And finally, ikhwan, I leave you with this tremendous athar, or hadith, shall I say, regarding how tawheed will help you. How having ma'rifat al-tawheed al-sahih, that having the correct understanding of tawheed, how that can aid you. And how that will help you. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذ اجتمع أهل النار في النار ومعهم من شاء الله من أهل القبلة. When the people were gathering the hellfire, and from the inhabitants of the hellfire will be those who Allah willed, من أهل القبلة, the people of the قبلة. Who are the people of the Qibla? Muslims. Yusalloon. This is a shahid of why the ulama say that the one that does not pray is not a Muslim. Ahl al-Qibla are the individuals that they perform the khamsa salawat. Al-Muhim. So they will be in the hellfire, and from amongst the people in the hellfire are Ahl al-Qibla. فَإِنَّ الْقُفَّارِ قال الكفار المسلمين. So the disbelievers and the wretched ones in the hellfire, they will say to the Muslims, ألم تكون المسلمين, mocking, wasn't you Muslims? Wasn't you Muslims? قالوا بلى. And they reply, indeed. قالوا فما أغنى عنكم الإسلام. So where is your Islam? What good did your Islam do? Then they will say, وَقَدْ سِرْتُمْ مَعْنَا فِي النَّارِ. So afwan, they will say, what good did your Islam do? And you have come with us to the hellfire. We're in the hellfire and you're in the hellfire. So بِمَعْنَا, what did your tawheed do? How did it benefit you? Because you're here with us. And the Muslims, they will reply by saying, كَانَتْ لَنَا ذُنُوب فَأُخِذْنَا بِهَا. We had sins and we are being punished for regarding our sins. فَسَمِيَ اللَّهَ مَا قَالُوا. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or not then, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hears what they say. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ever hearing. Allah azza wa jal hears what they say. And then Allah فَأَمَرَ بِمَنْ كَانَ فِي النَّارِ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْقِبْلَةِ فَأَخْرِجُوا. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will command and order anyone from Ahl al-Qibla, meaning the Muslims. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will order to remove them and take them out of the hellfire. فَلَمَّا رَأَى ذَلِكَ مِنْ مَنْ بَقِيَ مِنَ النَّارِ. And then when the ones that are remained in the hellfire will see this, then they will say, يَا لَيْتَنَا كُنَّا مُسْلِمِينَ. Oh, woe be to us if only we were Muslims. Woe be to us if only we were Muslims, then we likewise would be leaving now. And in another narration it mentions that the ones that come out of the hellfire, that they will be referred to as Jahannamiyun. They will be given that title. So then they will say to the Lord, Ya Rabbana adhib anna hadha al-ism. Oh, our Lord, remove from us this name and this lakab and this title. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cause them to be washed from the rivers of paradise, and then that name will be removed from them. So tawheed, ikhwan, having the correct understanding, knowing why the messengers came, the tawheed of uluhiyya, the tawheed of worship, these are from the asbab, ikhwan, that will protect us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbil Arsh al-Azim, and yunajjina min al-Nar, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He protects us from the hellfire. For verily there is a hadith that it mentions, and that we should always increase in seeking protection from the hellfire. And we should increase in asking Allah Azza wa Jal to enter us into paradise. For verily there is a hadith where the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that there is not a Muslim except that he says, Oh Allah, enter me into paradise three times. That the paradise itself will say, Oh Allah, enter him into paradise. And there's not a Muslim that says, Oh Allah, I seek refuge in you from the hellfire. Give me salvation from the hellfire three times. Except that the hellfire will say, Oh Allah, protect him from me. So increase in seeking refuge in Allah from the hellfire. And increase that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enters us into paradise. And likewise, the paradise, ikhwan, is the mercy of Allah. And bi idhnillah, after the salah, then our noble brother, Abu Hakim, hafidhullah ta'ala, well, inshallah, will enlighten our hearts after hearing such a heavy thing upon our hearts regarding the mercy of Allah and what paradise is and its rewards and its people. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for ikhlas. Wa aquli qawli hadha astaghfiru li wa lakum fastaghfiruhu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. Jazakumullahu khairan.